In this video, I'll be sharing with you three funds that you can get invested for March 2021. And they belong to this sector of energy. Yes, quite surprising, correct? As we see outflows from technology, perhaps energy may be a beneficiary of this recovery play. In a lot of ways, energy has been around for many decades. They have traditional energy like oil and gas, and right now, renewable energy, which is what I'll be covering with you in this presentation. Let me share with you my methodology also. When I select funds, I am actually looking how do they perform against benchmark. How do these funds stack up against each other among their peer groups? And last but not least, if I find any interesting stories within the fund itself, I also highlight in this presentation. So if this interests you, continue watching on. Hi guys, welcome back. Now, if you haven't been tracking, you may be surprised. Energy has done relatively well in this period. Let me show you the best performing funds for the last 6 months, and you would see that BNP Paribas Energy Transition Classic USD is the best performing fund over the last 6 months. Surprising, correct? And that'll be the second fund I'll be covering for today. The third fund will be something interesting, a competitor fund to this that I'd like to highlight to you, so stay tuned to the end. But let me start the presentation by highlighting the first fund in discussion, which is a top performing fund for 1 month comparison, which is BlackRock World Energy Fund. Now, BlackRock World Energy Fund invests in the traditional oil players. And you may be thinking, crazy, why invest in the oil players right now? But actually, Warren Buffett has actually bought stakes into Chevron stock. And Chevron, if you don't really know, is a major oil player. If you haven't seen oil movement in terms of the prices, let me show you this chart also here. This really shows you the recovery. The bottom, of course, was during the March and April period where oil was under tremendous stress because a lot of industrial outputs were shut down. But that recovery has been very quiet, but also very strong. I don't think a lot of news has actually mentioned the strong recovery in oil. So let me show you one particular article. Bank of America actually expects the fastest oil price rise in 30 years. Not only that, you see oil extends gains on OPEC with supply restraint. So oil is a commodity. It has always been, you know, associated to be fairly weak over the last few years, but the recovery is something that we need to pay attention to. So let's dive on very deeply into BlackRock World Energy Fund. They have a few currencies, and let me share with you the one that's SGD hash, just in case you're an investor from Singapore. The main thing that I can see over here is the top holdings: Total, Dutch Shell, Chevron, ConocoPhillips, ExxonMobil. Definitely brands that you may have heard of in one way or another. This is the best performing fund among its peers of traditional oil players, but it still underperformed the benchmark. And the 1 year underperformance is -0.5, 3 year underperformance -2.4. But nonetheless, in my opinion, it's still better than buying a single stock in the energy space itself. Because if we compare, if we put Chevron's share price against ExxonMobil's share price, against Shell's share price, you realize that it's not easy to pick winners. And maybe it's much better to be diversified, buy the whole basket. If the whole basket recovers, naturally you see positive performance, just like what I've shown in the previous 1 month chart, a positive 10%+ gain, which is unlike many other sectors which are seeing a correction right now. Let's move on to the second fund, which is BNP Paribas Energy Transition Classic Fund. If you don't really know the story in there's the hype going around renewable energy, let me show you a major, major announcement. This is actually President Biden's plan for clean energy revolution. Unlike his predecessor, President Trump, President Biden is very focused on clean energy, which includes batteries, which includes solar. There are so many sectors of renewable energy. There's even news of Biden's $2 trillion climate focused infrastructure plan, and they are definitely going to give a lot of loans and, you know, subsidies to clean energy players. That's why BNP Paribas fund actually benefited tremendously. If I can show you this, you realize that in the bottom part is the chart. It's actually underperformed its benchmark for quite a while, but recent year, especially 2020, it was a spectacular year for it. That's why I went to deep dive. What exactly is driving this outperformance over the benchmark? And what I realized in terms of top names are Plug Power, General Motors, Sunnova Energy International. If we look in terms of Plug Power, what exactly is Plug Power? Plug Power actually invests into hydrogen and fuel cell technology. So they are one of the players for renewable energy. What about Sunnova? They do actually solar panels for homes, something that Tesla is, you know, interested in also. But Sunnova, of course, is a much smaller player. So if we look in terms of these two names that I've highlighted, Plug Power, right now they are still in negative net income. 2020 was a loss year after a previous few years of losses also. What about for Sunnova? They are also currently loss-making. However, you'll be thinking loss-making might be a bad business or the share price will be performing quite poorly. Let me show the chart between Plug Power and Shell. And this is it. You realize that Plug Power has actually skyrocketed in 2020. Quite scary a rise, unlike Shell, which has actually fallen quite significantly with the oil price. And this growth in terms of share price, does that mean that, you know, it's right now in the bubble in terms of the renewable energy space? That I'm not 100% sure, but I have a few questions for you to ponder today, which is, in terms of renewable energy, there seems to be so many potential ideas. There is hydrogen, cell fuel, there is solar, there's wind, there's battery. If you're like me, like an outsider, why not buy a whole basket of funds whereby you get exposure into each and every sector? Let the fund manager decide which is possibly the dominant force, rather than buy a particular share and you get exposed only to one kind of renewable energy. So that's a quick thinking that I'd like to share with you today. This is an article in 2019, and what you realize is Bill Gates, Jeff Bezos, Jack Ma, these are among the wealthiest people in the world. They are actually pouring monies into clean tech ventures, but they seem to be starting the ventures themselves through their philanthropic organizations. So they could be in competition with all those Plug Power and Sunnova company eventually. So my understanding is might as well be diversified if you're already bullish about the sector itself. The third fund I have for you today is actually a competitor of the BNP Paribas Transition Energy Fund. And this fund is actually none other than BlackRock's Sustainable Energy Fund. If we put these two together, you realize that BlackRock's fund has actually significantly underperformed the BNP Paribas one, but it's still done very well. So I've done some research. Why exactly is the BlackRock one doing so differently in terms of performance, which is actually better moving forward? Because in any case, past performance does not indicate the future. What you want is to invest in the right sector in many ways. And what I can realize in terms of geographic breakdown is it's very different from the BNP Paribas Transition Energy Fund. This BlackRock Sustainable Energy Fund actually invests a lot into Europe. The second, third, fourth names are France, Germany, and Italy. And what you see over there is significant overweights over the benchmark. So perhaps this is really a European or global sustainable energy fund in some ways. If we plot the charts together, the first one being BNP Paribas Energy Transition Classic versus the BlackRock Sustainable Energy versus the BlackRock World Energy Fund, you realize that the best performing is the BNP Paribas one, but again, past performance does not guarantee the future. I do think that the BlackRock Sustainable Energy Fund is something quite interesting. So as I dug up its top name, I came across a company called Enel Spa. And this company is pretty interesting because it's actually a giant in Europe's energy space itself. What you can see over here is they've actually shown tremendous growth in terms of annual income. Not only that, you've also seen that they are actually profitable, unlike many of speculative ideas in the US renewable energy market. So Enel Spa is partly owned by Italian government, which means in any event of financial distress, you should expect, you know, certain government support in some ways. I do think it's a much better approach than buying some of the small cap US names. That's why in a lot of ways, I think this is a good name to look at. And the next thing I would like to typically focus on is what kind of valuations are there on the market. So Enel Spa right now is trading at 18.8 times price earnings ratio, which is very reasonable, especially with a blue chip status and in a favorable sector. It has solar, it has wind, it has geothermal, and it also has hydro, which it started more than 50 years ago. So they were clearly ahead of the innovation curve. And right now, hydro is the biggest source of renewable energy for the group itself. So what are your thoughts? If you believe renewable energy is something big in a 5-10 year time frame, are these two funds an idea for you? Or you prefer a traditional oil player like the BlackRock World Energy Fund? Leave them in the comment sections below. I'll be keen to hear from you also. And if you haven't subscribed, inviting you to do so, because when I release the ideas for April, I want you to get notified. With that, I have actually a previous video, I don't even seen it before, which is my best dividend stock for 2021. That company has actually exposure in the energy sector. Have you seen that video before? That actually touches on Bausteed, which is a listed company in Singapore. Bausteed has energy sector exposure, and its geospatial business also is involved in energy in some way. With that, if you haven't seen the presentation, it's a possible idea that you may be interested in, and I'd like to invite you to that video. So with that, I'll sign off, take care, and goodbye.